Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hi, hello, how are you? I am Kara. I like talking about makeup, beauty, and skincare. For today's video, it's going to be my monthly review video. So I'm going to be talking about my thoughts on the products that I have been using for the past months. So April and May siya, sharing my final thoughts about the Hydra Gloss from Issy & Co, Kimchi Chic Puff Puff Pass Set and Bake Powder, Vice Cosmetics Flawless Concealer as well as their Blending Sponge, Ever Milena Fearless Concealer as well as yung Strokes Beauty Labs Eye Paint Duo. Aside from talking about beauty reviews ng makeup and skincare, I also like to share with you my journey and overcoming overspending. I try to love the stuff that I have here. I try to use up the products that I currently have in my collection. And hopefully, that is something that you like. If you do so, please do subscribe to my channel. Then click on that notification bell right beside it so that you get notified whenever I make new videos. Now let's get started. Usually here in these types of videos, I review a lot of products all at the same time after I've tried them for a couple of times na within the month. Parang ganun. So right now, I tried April and May. Noong April, hindi ko na nagawan kasi sa May, puro madaming videos akong ginawa na first impressions. So dito ko kayo babalikan yung mga first impression videos ko. I-update ko lang kayo if there's anything new or if there's something worth adding on top of my first impressions review or nag-change ba yung mind ko. All the product links, prices will be listed down below as well as yung mga videos na kung kailan ko sila minention, yung first impression videos ko, lahat na sa baba sa Instagram, kung sa Instagram ko sila ni-review, ganyan, ililink ko yan lahat dyan sa baba for you guys to check it out if you want to. I'm just gonna start with the products that I've already created a dedicated video here in my channel para mabilis, and then I'll just move on yung mga Instagram na ni-review ko. So let's start first with the Get Ready With Me Cosmetics. Yung video na ginawa ko is a full review already because I've tried that several times bago pinot yung video na yun, hindi yun yung first time. So with this one, I could say that I really like it. So if you haven't checked out my video, then do check it out here. Ang gusto ko lang i-update dito is that yung mga negatives, although hindi ko na share siya doon sa initial video, but it's not relevant anymore kasi i-improve na nila yun. Like for example, itong Best Before sticker. Hindi ko masyadong nagustuhan yung sticker kasi natatanggal yung print. It's better na lang siguro talaga na in-imprint na nila dito, and I wish that the shade details will be here dun sa bottle mismo kasi nakakalito tsaka mahirap siyang basahin slight, no? If you read it from the bottom. But that's about it. Everything else is brilliant. As in, wala na talaga akong masabi pa. If you compare yung negatives ko versus yung mga positives ng With Me Cosmetics na creamy tint, wala lang sila, kiliti lang yun. The next thing that I want to review with you guys is yung EB Advanced Fearless Concealer. This one isn't my favorite. I compared this with the Caroline Concealer, and I also mentioned this briefly dun sa Vice Cosmetics video ko to compare. Full coverage siya, medyo thick for me, and hindi ko to nagustuhan partly because of the shade that I got. It's called Oriental. Just doesn't fit my needs, so hindi ko to pinaka-favorite na concealer out of dun sa tatlo na nabinili ko. Yung Flawless, yung Caroline, tsaka ito. Ito na siguro yung pinaka-last. I like the Doe Foot. Yun lang. Yun lang na gusto ko sa kanya. Yung Doe Foot lang. Ang gusto ko sa concealer is yung medium coverage na slightly lighter than my skin tone. Nag-oxidize pa to, guys. So, pag nilagay ko siya sa under eyes ko, talagang maitim siya. So, kitang-kita ko talaga yung kulay. So, maybe if I got a lighter shade, yung shade na swak talaga sa akin, maybe my review for this one would be better, but with the Caroline that I have and as well as yung Vice Cosmetics concealer, I wouldn't reach for this, and I wouldn't be inclined to buy another, you know, shade of this one. Strokes Beauty Lab Eye Paint Duos. I have this in the shade Purple Luster and in the shade Midnight Galaxy. I'm actually wearing Purple Luster today in my eyes. Yung shimmer doon sa lids ko and then yung matte side on the lower lash line. Update ko lang na yung shimmer, slightly nagka-crack siya if you put a lot. I wouldn't suggest you put the shimmer on your eyelids kasi kung saan nagkakaroon ng fold-fold yung eyes mo. Mafe-feel mo talaga may konting tackiness, and I feel like pag nag-fold siya, nagsistick sila sa isa't isa. And so, napipeel off niya yung isang side, parang ganon. And then, makikita mong splotchy siya. If I move you guys closely into my eyes right now, ayan, makikita nyo na may pagka-konting, di ba parang splotchy siya? Pero pag, if you look straight, it looks fine. Pero kung saan nagme-meet yung skin ko, kung nag-fold yung skin ko, doon siya nagiging patchy. And that doesn't look nice. Wala naman, wala akong masabi dun sa matte side. The matte side is good. Hindi siya nag-crease, not like yung shimmer. Mabilis siyang i-blend, mabilis siyang i-spread, mabilis lang nga siya mag-dry down. But once you get the hang of it, I think that you're okay with it. I wouldn't recommend Midnight Galaxy to beginners just because of the color kasi baka ma-overwhelm ka. But if you practice it and if you know how to work with the formula already, then I think it's good. You can blend it out with a brush, pero mas magandang ma-blend out mo siya before it dries down. Kasi pag nag-dry down mo siya, tapos i-blend it out, then it becomes patchy. I still like this product to the point that I bought 2 shades pa nung 6-6 sale. Mga cons lang siya that I feel like I could work around it. So disappointing lang talaga yung shimmer shades kasi gusto ko yung shimmers on my eyelids. So baka sa lower lash line ko na lang ilalagay yung mga shimmer shades ko, inner corner, or somewhere around my eye that doesn't have a lot of folds. Medyo mahal siya because of the component, because of the packaging, pero a little goes a long way and very pigmented siya. Sana they release more colors, no? The next one that I want to talk about here is yung Vice Cosmetics Blending Sponge and yung Vice Cosmetics Loleza Conceal and Perfect. This one, guys, I've tried this several times. I used it with my fingers, I used it with my brush, I used this with my sponge. Lahat sila okay. I really like this concealer. I know that a lot of people don't like this. Karang hindi nila ganun kabet because of the coverage, because of the dry down, or nag-oxidize, ganyan. Sa akin, hindi siya nag-oxidize. And kung nag-oxidize siya dun sa under eyes ko, it's fine. I like medium coverage concealer. It's fine kahit may kita kong konting under eyes. Hindi ko rin kasi ganun kagusto yung sobrang wala akong under eyes. I don't know, it just doesn't look so natural to me. And I like na it dries down kasi hindi siya nag-crease and it stays all day. And very lightweight din siya. Alam mo yung i-apply mo lang siya and then you can forget it. You don't have to apply powder. Na little things lang that I appreciate. And when I place this on my pimple, alam ko na hindi matatanggal yung concealer. Hindi siya mag-fade, hindi siya mabura, ganun. To me, hindi rin nagda-dry siya dun sa under eyes ko. But probably because marami ako nilalagay sa face ko na moisturizing products dun sa skincare ko. So if you wanna see how I prep my skin sa skincare, watch this video here and watch, I'll link it also down below so that you know, no? Yung blending sponge, I like this blending sponge a lot. As in, super na-enjoy ko siya gamitin. I like na it gets big. Pag malaki yung sponge, mas kaya kong i-cover yung face ko. Mas madali akong maka-makeup. Kaya niya rin na mag-concealer. And I like blending, using this sponge to blend this concealer. Right now, today, I use a different sponge kasi. And na-miss ko to. If you want to get both of these, so I hope that you could get na lang sana yung bundle na perfect match bundle kasi mas sulit yun in my opinion. And the next product that I will be talking about itong Issy & Co. Hydra Gloss. Guys, ang pinaka-complaint ko lang is yung si Surf. Medyo oily siya. Parang runny siya. Medyo runny siya yung formula compared to the other 3 shades. And then yung applicator niya is something that is poking me. Nilagay ko dun sa pin comment ko ng first impressions ko na video, which I'll link it here and I'll link it down below as well. Pinin comment ko kasi doon yung paano talaga gamitin yung applicator. And, you know, it's still different. Kailangan mo mag-adjust lang slight. Pero after you get the hang of it, parang second nature na yun for me. Hindi na siya something that I have to always keep on remembering. Mapapansin mo na lang na ganun na pala yung ginagawa mo. I think that how they designed the doe foot is brilliant. And the formula talaga is something that's out of this world. Kakaiba talaga. Like for me, this one, I'm wearing bikini right now mixed with mixed berries from Get Ready With Me Cosmetics to try to tone it down. Colored shades talaga yung pinaka favorite ko. Si Surf, I tried this sa gabi. Pagising ko sa umaga, grabe, sobrang soft ng lips ko. It just really keeps it soft. Pagising mo, kahit may konting product niyan, kahit pagtanggal mo ng product from your lips, it's still hydrated, no? May kamahalan lang siya, slight, but because of the quality, because of what it does, ma-justify ko na talaga yung price point niya. If you want to get this, if you feel like this is a little too expensive for you, mag-abang ka talaga ng sale. SCN Co. is very, very generous when it comes to sales. Whew! Okay, that's it for everything that I have, you know, created a separate video here on my YouTube. I also did create, you know, several other videos sa Instagram naman. So, let's start with this one. Ito yung Kimchi Chic Puff Puff Pass Set and Bake Powder. I'll link my video na lang sa Beauty M&L. They did send this to me to review and I sent my review over to Beauty M&L. So, if you haven't seen that, I'll link it here down below as well dun sa description box so that you can check it out. This powder is very, very fine. It feels so weightless and you really wouldn't see na cakey siya sa face mo. Ang kinakatakutan ko lang kasi with powders is that most of the time they look super matte, they look flat, and then it dries out my skin. I have dry skin kasi. Ito actually yung powder na ginamit ko when I was testing out the Get Ready With Me Cosmetics. Kahit na 9 hours kung sinuot yung makeup na yon, sobrang fresh ko pa rin. Tapos grabe, pinagpapawisan na ako noon. Hindi ako naka-aircon, hindi ako naka-electric fan. Sobrang init kasi may yung mga lights ko, mainit yan eh. Sobrang fresh ko pa rin. And nakakatuwa lang talaga kasi hindi ako nag-retouch. Hindi ako nag-retouch ng powder, hindi ako nag-anything. As in, kung ano yung suot ko nung kakalagay ko lang ng product, yun rin yung suot ko hanggang doon sa pinakahuli. I could say that this is a powder that I would probably wear when I want to look really good, if you want to look fresh all day. Ang downside ko lang for me is that the packaging, although cute siya with the pink and yung heart yung sifter niya, na-spoil na kasi ako with the packaging of Hailey Beauty and yung SCN Co. Yung may takip na ganito, tapos may mirror pa sa likod, cover pa, tapos yung net yung ano. So, when it comes to this, it is messy. Everything that I don't like about loose powder packaging is in here. My puff ka, and the puff is the only thing that's keeping the product from flying around. Now that I've experienced this, parang ang sobrang inconvenient lang neto. Price point wise, I think 1,000 pesos to for 24 grams of product. It's kind of on the pricey side kasi ito nga, 24 grams, 25 grams, but mga 200 something pesos lang siya, diba? Sobrang sulit. Yung performance-wise of these two, kakaiba. This is more of a dewy finish. Mas nag-oil up ako dito, dun sa Hailey Beauty Powder compared to this one. Kasi ito talaga, sobrang fresh lang talaga yung face ko. So, yeah, ang masasabi ko lang talaga is the packaging, yung pinaka-cont niya. And maganda rin dito, marami siyang shade range. Malaki yung shade range niya. Takot nyo na lang, may mga powders din siya for color correcting. Sobrang happy lang ako that Beauty M&L reached out to me to review this. So, to receive this in PR. Kasi, honestly, I wouldn't pay for 1,000 pesos na powder. But I'm happy that this is in my collection. Next thing that blew me away was actually this mascara. Ito yung BLK Cosmetics Volume Boost Waterproof Mascara. I was actually not into buying this kit. Pero what made me buy this was when Liz Lanuzo, yung owner ng Project Vanity, owner din ng In Her Element. I really like her review of this one, yung BLK Cosmetics. They have very sparse hairs talaga and straight pa, tapos hindi pa nag-curl. So ito, when I saw her review, grabe, as in, nakita ko talaga with my own eyes how the mascara was able to make her lashes look so good. Sige, binili ko na. Try ko lang. Sige, buy it na. So, binili ko to ng 5-5. And can I just say, it's one of the best mascaras that I have tried na local. And I'm really happy kasi not a lot of brands release mascaras actually. So, pagka-try ko to, as in, sobrang natuwa ko as I apply layers upon layers of this mascara on my lashes. I could really see the mascara still holding its shape up. As in, ang ganda. Hindi siya nagiging spidery. Hindi rin siya yung parang clumpy yung itsura agad. As in, sobrang defined yung lashes ko na parang woof! Ganon. If I were to compare the Super Mega Ultra Curl with this one, yung Super Mega Ultra Curl, not waterproof, tubing mascara yon, water resistant lang yon. Ito waterproof. Volumizing Super Mega Ultra Curl would win. Ito may fibers, so lengthening yung more of the strength niya for me. Kahit na lengthening to, mas lengthening pa rin si Super Mega Ultra Curl Mascara. When it comes to curling, ito talaga super duper duper nice. Yung pag-separate niya, yung clumping, both of them don't clump. But si Super Mega Ultra Curl, since mas volumizing siya, mas kaya niyang magmukhang pack agad. So, ang ginagawa ko na lang with this one is that I use this first sa lashes ko para ma-define niya yung hairs ng lashes ko tsaka ma-keep niya yung curl. Once that dries down, I move on with layering Super Mega Ultra Curl. So, I feel like this combo, ito na siguro yung pinaka nag-work for me nung sa Get Ready With Me Cosmetics na video ko. Hindi rin ako nag-wear ng false lashes. I've been enjoying just my own lashes. I love them both. Both of them have their own strengths and weaknesses, and I find that these two just complement each other very well. This one I bought is from Roman. Ito yung lasting water tint nila. Binili ko to buy one take one kasi nung 5-5. And sobrang natuwa ako, guys, kasi matagal ko nang minamatahan to, like I said. And can I just say na sobrang ganda nito? I love the quality of Roman, and I get why the hype is there. It really does look like a glossy tint na juicy. Sobrang juicy siya. Glass-like talaga yung itsura niya. Oh, I'm in love. Yung itsura niya is like you put the lip tint, tapos naglagay ka ng lip gloss. And very moisturizing. Maganda yung flavor. I love it. Madaling i-apply. Ang cool nga nung doe foot niya kasi straight lang siya na doe foot. One straight point. Wala siyang slanted edge or something. I wouldn't pay full price for this one though. Can I just say, just because na I'm a cheap person, kung kaya ko mas mura, ibilhin ko yun ng mas mura. Don't expect though na yung lips mo magmumukhang as juicy as the promotional pictures that they are showing on their marketplace pages. But you can put lip gloss din na additional on top of that product para mas extra juicy siya. Next thing that I wanna talk about with you is from Dear Self Beauty, itong si Penny. Ever since I got this, guys, as in so in love talaga ako dito sa lippy na to. Ang ganda-ganda talaga. I love the shade. I love the shade so much. Cool tone pink shade siya na may pagka-konting brown. And ang ganda lang talaga niya. I don't know. Yung formula neto is very creamy. Tapos yung dry down niya medyo matagal. But it does dry down into a matte finish na hindi siya tacky or something. I would still prefer yung Ofra liquid lipstick na formula. But this one comes close second. I like this more than yung Colorette Velvet Tint kasi yung Velvet Tint medyo nagda-dry siya slight and mas mabilis yun mag-dry down. Yeah, parang sobrang soft lang ng formula niya. Hindi niya na masyadong na-emphasize yung lines ng lips ko. I wouldn't say na blurring siya ng parang velvet na itsura talaga. Transfer proof siya and it's also blendable in a sense that kaya mo mag-ombre lips with this na parang lagay mo lang siya dito sa inner corner mo tapos pucker your lips and then it looks pretty nice na. Understand why Cassie, yung friend ko sa Instagram, si Cassie Sandoval, hello! Sobrang love niya talaga tong lippy na to. So this is the Dear Self Beauty Blur Matte in Penny, ayan. Love it! I love it so much! So, konting products na lang, guys. Both of them are Korean brands. So, let's first talk about Merzy. Ito yung Merzy Heritage Collection nila, yung Velvet Tint. They sent this to me in PR. And I have it in the shade V20, V22, 21, and 19. Now, formula of this one is slightly thinner doon sa blue velvet nila na line. Yung blue or red na shade na tube, yung naka-squarish na shape. Pag kinumpare ko yung shades nila, medyo similar sila sa isa't isa. Sa labi mo, hindi mo na siya ganun ka mapapansin eh. Nag-dry yung lips ko dito, guys. Very smooth. Maganda yung quality niya, but I slightly prefer the blue velvet or the red velvets more than this one. It's not the usual shades that I reach out for. Ang pinaka-favorite ko na dito siguro is yung tortoise. Hindi ko lang kung anong shade nun. Parang yung sa 100% sugar ng Get Ready With Me Cosmetics. Ganun yung shades niya. No? So the next thing that I wanna talk about from Merzy is their eyeshadow. So their Mood Fit Shadow Palette. Ayan, I have all four. And they did send this to me in PR as well. They have three shades. Itong si Amusing Rose, si Joyful Coral, tsaka si Drowsy Nude. So, out of all, I'll show you some swatches here dito sa side na to para makita nyo. I also did a demo of this one on my Instagram already. So, the eyeshadow comes in this parang small, compact na quad lang siya. There are three mattes and then there's one shimmer. Finish ng shimmer niya is very glittery yung itsura niya. Pero hindi yung rough glitters na nag-fall out, ganon. Wala ko na-experience na anything bad with this product. They apply very smoothly on the lids. They blend very easily. I like the quality of their eyeshadow. It's more of that dry, silky smooth na powder. Hindi siya buttery soft na parang nagme-melt siya sa hands mo. And yung sa shimmers niya, you know how I feel about shimmers. I really like the shimmers in this. I think that it's dimensional. There's, you know, it's very interesting na may iba-ibang shades. At some point, para may blue na shimmers siya dito na maliliit. And parang glittery yung effect niya. But not glittery na chunky, ganon. The pigmentation is okay, buildable, blendable, ganon. Parang medyo hard yung pag-press ng powders dito. But it doesn't compromise the performance of the powders on your eyes. I didn't feel na nag-fall out siya. I didn't feel like, you know, naging messy yung pag-blend or patchy siya. I didn't feel that in any of these eyeshadow palettes. The price naman here is kind of on the expensive side for just being a quad. To me kasi, having such a huge collection, I could really tell you guys na hindi ko ito mauubos kahit na 2 years, 3 years, ganyan. Hindi ko ito mauubos. Baka nga wala pang panto. So, to me, pag ganon, hindi siya sulit in that sense. If you're someone who's looking for an eyeshadow palette that you're gonna use every day, na yun na lang talagang gagamitin mo hanggang sa maubos siya, then I think it's worth it. The eyeshadow colors are not that special naman, in my opinion. You're gonna get really soft looks here. May colors, but neutrals. Okay, last two products, and this one came from Althea when they sent me PR package. Brow Wow Eyebrow Pencil nila. I have it in the shade Gray Brown and I have it also in the shade Soft Brown. Yung isang shade, which I forgot, I'm just gonna put swatches here as well. I like this eyebrow pencil. It glides on easily. Yung pigmentation niya is very soft. Hindi rin siya yung sobrang pigmented na ma-overwhelm na sobrang blocky na agad yung brows mo. Makikita ko yung sarili ko na gagamitin ko to hanggang sa maubos. I like na yung spoolie nila is not yung very flat, na parang may konting curve siya. Hindi rin siya waxy, na nag-skip yung product. Beginner-friendly itong eyebrow pencil na to. Wala pang 5 minutes matatapos ko na yung brows ko with these two products. I'm not sure if I'm gonna repurchase this just because ang dami ko pang eyebrow pencils right now. But it's not, you know, a standard favorite. Hindi rin naman kasi ako mapili with eyebrow pencils eh. It's not bad. It's not bad. And the last thing that I wanna share with you guys, yung Baby Meringue Puff nila. They sent me the big one and yung small ones. Kinuha ko na lang yung small ones. Yung big one nilagay ko dun sa giveaway. It's very soft naman. Tsaka muro lang to, guys. Very affordable. So, ito yung size niya. Ito yung na-wet na. And ito yung parang dry. Ayan. May kita mo, lumaki naman siya slight. And I find that the shape is, you know, very weird. Mahirap yung angle niya, in my opinion. Nitong angle niya. I wish that it was a little elongated, slightly. Mas teardrop yung shape niya. Then I think it's much easier to, you know, use all the sides. Kasi I like the point, I like the flat surface. But I don't know where to use this parang curve edge niya dito. Other than that, it's okay. It's an okay product. I would still prefer the Vice Cosmetics sponge over these ones. But it's nice to have lang sila. But it's not something that I think is necessary for everyone. Kanya-kanyang style naman din kasi yan sa pag-apply ng makeup mo. So yeah, that is it guys for my review video. It's not super in-depth. Don't expect na with these types of videos, super in-depth ako na talagang I really go and dwell with all the products. I just wanna report kung ano yung pinaka-thoughts ko. Not so much on the details. The details I'll list down below. Kung nagawan ko na ng video, again, I'll list down below. So I hope that you enjoy this video. I hope that you found more information with these products. Sana na yung dun sa mga ginawan ko ng video na. And thank you so much for supporting my channel. I'm really, really happy. I'm just gushing over the weekend. Hit ko na yung 1,000 subscribers. And so yeah, thank you so much for watching this guys. I hope that you enjoyed your day and I'll see you in the next video. Much love. Bye bye.